Following the 3D noise and mask tutorial, I'll show you today how I achieved my confined noise generative artwork. I already have a code with me video, but I got a comment on that video that they would prefer talking videos over time lapses with music. And I agree. Still, you know, not every generative artwork requires a full 30-minute tutorial to get the point across, because it might seem redundant. Therefore, instead of making a full tutorial repeating everything I already explained in the 3D noise tutorial, I'm simply continuing from there, explaining the parts where I converted that artwork into this one. Without the masks, of course. We'll make something a little different and make the noise loop using part of the code from this coding train video. Let's start. One of the main differences is the bounce method for each agent. So let's start by implementing that inside of the agent class. So now we constrain the agents inside of the canvas borders. We'll do precisely the same thing, but the barrier for each agent will be a cell on a grid. I chose to make the number of agents the same number of cells on the grid, so we naturally get only one agent per cell. You can easily create more and then define which agents take which cells randomly, that's up to you. I'll initialize a grid to save each cell's position and use them as the beginning position for each agent. I'll then pass in these positions to the agent and pass in the width and height of the cells. Now, if you have a square canvas, you only need one argument for width, but I'll do two for the cell width and height. I like to prepare for different resolutions for later use if I ever come back to it and need, let's say, a thumbnail for this video. I'm going to need a width that is different from the height, so this will account for that. All we need to do now is define those parameters inside the agent class and use them to constrain each agent to their new bounds. And voila, they're bound to their cells. Go watch the code with me video for the vertices design, because we'll do something different here. In that video, I created a loop inside the display method to connect all the noise movement using vertices to create random curves. But here, we'll use a point with random stroke weights and colors. Simple. I also want to make the movement loop using the coding train video on looping noise. That tutorial explains the whole concept. Daniel Schiffman is best at explaining concepts like these. I'll only show you how I applied that code into my work. I created a new class called Noise, and in it, I applied the loop from that video with a few changes here and there. I'll link to this sketch file in the description. In short, you create points around a circle with radii controlled by noise, creating a looping animation, saving every point value in the process for later use. Instead of the original noise for angle, I'll initialize a new noise object inside the agent class and use that for the angle variable in the update method. When I run this, we should get a looping animation with noise. Because we initialize all agents in the original cells, when you save this, the first frame will not match the last frame. So I start saving from the second loop. That starts from the size of the noise array to double that number. And your design should loop. That's just my hack, but I'm sure someone can come up with something crazy clever in the comments that I'm missing or simply don't know. I think I'll have to change a few things here and there to get the first position from the noise rather than getting the first position that I set based on the positions in the cells of the grid. So leave a comment down below if you have a shortcut to how to do this. Well, this was a very short video, so I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll talk to you soon.
Come tend the garden with me. We have so many seeds to sow. When the harvest comes in, it will be time to share what we have grown. Time of our lives when we started.